Hi, my name is Matt Sigmund with Performance Designs. Today we're going to show you how to do a continuity check. It's always a good idea to do a continuity check when you first receive your canopy or you get it back from any kind of maintenance. To start off, the first thing we're going to do is lay down the rig, stretch out the canopy, and make sure none of our risers are twisted up. It helps at this point to lay down a weight on top of your risers, keep them in place. To make things easy for ourselves, at this point we're going to take the slider and bring it all the way down to the container. Right now, we're gonna grab the lines like we're gonna be packing a canopy. So we're gonna take our steering lines and put them in between our index finger and our thumb, our C's and D's and put them in between our index finger and our middle finger, and our A's and B's and put them in between our ring finger and our middle finger. Once we have them in between our fingers, we're gonna walk down to the canopy. After we walk down to the canopy, we're gonna drop the A's and B's, make sure there's no entanglement. Everything's good on both sides. We're gonna drop the C's and D's. Make sure there's no entanglement with the steering lines. And once we see that the C's and D's are clear from the steering lines, we're gonna drop it all and get ready to do a span-wise continuity check. Now on different canopies, it's gonna be a little bit different. Right now we're working with Valkyrie. So on the outside, you're only gonna have a C line. You're not gonna have that cascaded to a D line. So now we're gonna pick up the steering line, put it behind our head. So we're gonna take that cascaded line, we're gonna place it in between our thumb and our index finger. And we're gonna go down the span tape, find our next group of lines. We're gonna take them and place them in between our index finger and our middle finger. Now we're gonna go span-wise down again and put that line group in between our middle finger and our ring finger. Then we're gonna go span-wise down again, grab that last group, put it in between our ring finger and our pinky finger. So once you have the lines in your fingers, now we're gonna walk it all the way down to the container, making sure that there's no twist in the lines and that the lines are in the proper order on your slink. If you find a twist here or you see that the lines are in an improper order, do it one more time. See if you get the same results, and if you do, go grab your local rigger or experienced jumper. We're gonna do the same procedure we did with the rear riser group. This time we're gonna take the rear riser group and the steering line and place it behind our head. Now we're gonna go down and grab the outside A's and B's, place them in between our thumb and pointer finger, follow span-wise down. Next group we're gonna put in between our pointer finger and our middle finger, follow span-wise down. Next group goes in between our middle finger and our ring finger. Then we're gonna go span-wise down again, grab that last group, put it in between our ring finger and our pinky finger. And just like we did with the rear riser group, once we have the lines in between our fingers, we're gonna walk them down to the container, make sure there are no twists in the risers and that the lines are in the proper order. So once you're finished with the one side, we're gonna drop everything and move over to the other side and do the same thing. So at any point during this, if you find any twists in your riser in the lines or your lines are out of order, don't hesitate to go grab your local rigger or any more experienced jumper to help you out with this. So hopefully with this, you can do your own continuity checks. You've checked both span-wise and cord-wise continuity. Go out there, make a bunch of jumps, and have fun.